Now we straight take you to 82-year-old alumni, an 82-year-old alumni who passed out from the school 65 years before. He has passed out 65. I think most of the people who are on the screen might not have been born even at that time. When 65 years ago, in 1955, he passed out, and he is Mr. Raghunathan, who is joining
Yes,
us.
I am here.
Raghunathan from
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Raghunathan, sir, please go ahead. Welcome you.
Yeah, thank you so much. See, all this time I was struggling for the internet, and just now I got it.
Sir, but we are not able to see you. We are not able to see you. We want to see you also.
Let me try. Answers are quite new to me.
Quite right, sir. Definitely.
Are you able to see me now?
No, not yet, sir.
Not
at the age of 82, if you are still trying to do all this, it's a great thing. And we are your inspiration to all of us. We learn a lot.
Perfectly. I mean, that's how it has to be. Like, well, then we live. Like, I just wanted to say a few words to my alumni friend. Forget about if I'm not able to see me in the screen.
No, mind, sir.
Yeah, I think I'll say a few words. Like, first of all, let me introduce myself to the alumni friends who may not know me. My name is Raghunathan, R. Raghunathan. I passed out in 1955 from Madrasi Education Association High Secondary School. Yes, that was the name then, MEH School and Reading Road. After only it became Mandir Mark, till then it was Reading Road. I remember a lot of things about that school, my down the memory lane when I go through. I remember the big vista of the school opening with a flight of about 30, 40 steps. And then to the right, you have the Birla Mandir, to the left, the Raisna Bengali High School. And behind the school was a huge ridge, which almost takes about half an hour for one to cross through to the go to the backside, which is known as Karol Bagh. Well, this is about what I enjoyed there. And the faculties, I remember distinctly few names. One, Mr. Surya Narayanan, who was my principal, Mr. Rajagopal, who was my maths teacher, Mr. Rajaram, who was my chemistry teacher, Madam Maitri was my chemistry assistant, and I had Mr. Srinivasan, who was my physics teacher, Mr. Kaju was my English teacher, and one Mr. Sharma was my geography teacher. That's about the people whom under whom I got trained and who taught me what all think about. And I also can recall a few of my classmates. One I can very distinctly remember is one N. Saroja, who always used to stand first in the class. She used to be the first and followed by one Rajaram, who used to be second. I normally used to be in the third, but it was such a tough competition, I was never able to climb up to either the second position or the first position. Very more friends in the schoolmates like M. Srinivasan, M. Sundaresan, and so on and so forth. Well, this is about my background of the school. And coming to think about the generations that I've just passed out from the school has sprawled itself into many branches. And I believe already something like 30,000 and odd are the alumni of this school. I still would like to say that there are the people who have passed out maybe belonging to my second or even the third generations. Therefore, I have a bit of a good thing, a few things to tell them about. Like life is tough. We all started in the school and we learned the basics of life. And as we grew older and older, we started learning all about the skills and the ways of the world. It started becoming tougher. Even today, life is not all that simple. There are ups and downs. There are good things and bad things. But one should live through it, live through every moment of it, and enjoy life, because life is something wonderful. Therefore, we should have the resilience and be able to put up with all this and be able to come out and what gives the best challenge to us is the peers who can give us the best challenge. And if we can have a mentor who can really take us above, I think we will be the most successful people. Now, regarding what the other alumni members can do or can all do to the institution, is that, yes, by way of monetary help, we can donate some books and stationery. We can perhaps help you in some projects that the school is going to undertake, either personally or online, by suggestions and consultations. We can also help the school in trying to get a name for it by carrying the goodwill to the outside world. I also feel that we can help a lot the students who are coming out, either passed out already or the process of passing out, to get them a good berth, to get them a good placements in the outside world. I think these are the ways that we can help the student community and the school to be able to perform better in the future. Well, at this juncture, I do feel that I would like to just browse on one particular point, that this present pandemic that is taking the whole world by a big jolt is really something we have to overcome. Well, I very strongly believe that, like any other virus that had come in the past, like any other great crisis that had come in the past, we would be able to overcome this. It will probably dwindle, and one fine morning, they will be there, but we still be there. But one thing is very, very important lesson that we learned, that we have abused the nature. Nature has been abused to the extent that it is so harsh with us, that this is one way of trying to tell us that you better behave, otherwise you will not exist. Therefore, my humble suggestion to all these fellow students and the people around and the people around, let us wake up and let us look at the very, very, very important things. But here, the citizens of the whole world should come together. There is nothing like a continent or a country or affluent levels or good or bad or black or white or race or religion, nothing of these sorts. We all have to, each one of us have to come out. And the first thing is we have probably overgrown in size. We were 1.6 billion in 1900 at the start of the 20th century, but today we are 7.8 billion. I think we've almost grown five times more. We didn't know when to stop, but today what has happened is we have overgrown so much. We have deforested all the valuable lands. The afforestation must take place. The water quality has become very bad. We have to leave something for the future. Talk about global warming, look at any side. The science of sustainability that we are talking about, which should have been started long year back. All these things focus on one thing, that we are almost at the edge of this planet, and we need to recharge and come back to save this planet. And the only way we can save the planet is we have to sacrifice. We have to have no more luxuries. We need to have no more comfort. Yes, a time will come when we try to consolidate the present position, and we should dwell upon a life of minimalization, and that only can salvage the present situation, and we'll come out of it. I'm sure we'll be able to come out of it, and we will see one day that we all go back to the old life. And I wish you all the best, and I'm very happy for having got this opportunity to talk to you in a brief while. Thanks a lot, and God bless you all. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We pray that you continue up to 100 and beyond 100 also, and continue to inspire us and bless us all. And we
thank
always
you.
Like to seek your guidance in going for the things.
We thank have, you.
Thank you, Mr. And we have Sunita Chauhan back with us. She's a 1990 alumni of the Arkepuram School who just presented her a kavita. Can I have Sunita Chauhan for a minute? Just a short introduction.
Sukumar sir, your speaker, your voice is not audible.
My mic is also on. Sunita is there.
Sukumar?
Yeah, Sunita, please continue for a minute.
Yeah, she has been introduced.
Yeah.
So, Sunita.
Sir, आप मुझे देख पा रहे हैं?
हाँ जी.
Carry on, Sunita ji.
सबसे पहले तो जैसे कि मैंने अपने रिकॉर्डिंग में भी कहा, आप सभी के सामने मुझे कुछ बोलते हुए भी बड़ा अजीब सा लग रहा है. मुझे समझ नहीं आ रहा कि मैं मेरे रोंगटे खड़े हो रहे हैं, मैं खुश हूँ या मैं बहुत ज्यादा खुश हूँ या मैं बहुत बहुत ज्यादा खुश हूँ आप सबसे जुड़ने के लिए कि आपने मुझे ये मौका दिया. आप सभी मुझसे बहुत बहुत ज्यादा सीनियर भी हैं और बहुत ही अनुभवी भी हैं. अभी मैंने जिन सबको भी सुना, अपने सीनियर्स को, और इतना अच्छा लगा कि सब लोग इतना कुछ कर रहे हैं. तो आप सबके सामने तो वो कहते हैं कि सागर में मोती के समान आप लोग हैं, कि एक एक मोती अपने आप में बहुत कीमती है, लेकिन मैं सिर्फ सागर की एक बूंद हूँ. और बूंद को जब ये मौका मिलता है कि वो अपने बारे में कुछ बता सके, तो आप समझ सकते हैं कि मुझे कितना अच्छा लग रहा होगा. और डीटीए ने जो मैं आपको अगर मैं बताना चाहूँ, क्योंकि मैं, आप जानते हैं कि मैं रेडियो पर हूँ और हमें लफाजी करने की आदत होती है, लेकिन हम दिल से बोलते हैं. हमें समझ नहीं आता कि कैसे चीजों को घुमा फिरा के बोला जाए, हमें वो नहीं आता है. इसलिए मैं भी वैसी ही हूँ कि मैं बिल्कुल सीधे सीधे बोलती हूँ. और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जो डीटीए ने हमें दिया, सबसे बड़ी बात, जो कॉन्फिडेंस दिया कि आप जाके किसी से कैसे बात करते हैं, क्या करते हैं, तो अभी जो मैंने देखा डॉक्टर ईश्वरन को, डॉक्टर उमा को, और साथ ही जो गाने हमने सुने उनसे, तो मुझे ये लगा कि आप लोग इतना कुछ करते हैं, उसके बाद जब आपको रिलैक्स करना होता है तो आप म्यूजिक सुनते हैं. लेकिन मेरा काम ऐसा है कि मैं, मेरा पूरा काम ही ऐसा है कि मैं वो गाने सुनवाती हूँ. और साथ हमारा जो एफएम गोल्ड का जो टारगेट ऑडियंस है वो 35+ है, यानी कि सारा रेट्रो हिंदी फिल्म म्यूजिक हम प्ले करते हैं. और बहुत अच्छा लगता है, अगर आप कभी सुनेंगे तो आपको भी एहसास होगा कि वो पुराने गाने जो सब लोग भूल रहे हैं, वो दोबारा से जब आप सुनते हैं तो आप एक अलग ही दुनिया में वापस चले जाते हैं. तो आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. मैं सिर्फ इतना कहना चाहूंगी डीटीए आर्कपुरम के एलुमनाई होने के नाते कि जैसे कि मैम ने भी कहा कि हमने बहुत कुछ किया है अपने स्कूल के लिए, सभी एलुमनाई ने बहुत कुछ किया है, लेकिन हम चाहते हैं कि ये रिश्ता कायम रहे. कई बार ऐसा होता है कि कोई भी चीज, कोई भी रिश्ता निभाने के लिए दोनों तरफ से पहल की जानी जरूरी होती है. तो हम चाहेंगे कि वो बीच में जो कम्युनिकेशन गैप आ जाता है वो ना आए, हमें वो प्यार, वो मोहब्बत वो मिलती रहे, जिससे कि वो जो रिश्ता, वो राबता है, वो कायम रहे हमारे बीच में. क्योंकि हम अभी भी वही हैं, हम अभी भी वही हैं जो वहाँ प्रेयर करते थे, हम अभी भी वही हैं जो उस पार्क में जाके हमें याद आ जाता है जो हम खिलाते करते थे. हमें अभी भी याद है कि हम अपने टीचर्स के साथ कितनी मस्ती करते थे. तो हमें बस यही चाहिए कि हमें उस स्कूल के साथ हमारा रिश्ता कायम रहे, जैसे हम पहले बातचीत करते थे. अगर कुछ भी है तो वो जो कम्युनिकेशन है वो क्लियर रहना चाहिए. और हम हमेशा अपनी मैम से कहना चाहेंगे, हम हमेशा यही हैं, हम हमेशा यही थे और हम हमेशा यही रहेंगे अपने स्कूल के लिए, जिसने हमें इतना कुछ दिया और हमें यहाँ तक पहुँचाया. तो आप सभी का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. और मैं किसी भी तरह से किसी के भी काम आ पाऊँ, जो मेरे अंदर जो भी काबिलियत है, अगर किसी भी तरह से आपको मेरी ज़रूरत हो तो आप मुझे ज़रूर बता सकते हैं. और सबसे ज़्यादा शुक्रिया सुकुमार सर आपका कि आपने जब कल मुझसे बात की, मुझे इतना अच्छा लगा कि जब मेरे मम्मी पापा की शादी हुई थी उस वक्त आपने स्कूल पास कर लिया था. तो ये मेरे लिए बहुत फख्र की बात है कि आपने मुझसे बात की. और मैं आपको बता नहीं सकती कि मेरे जो अंदर के भाव हैं, जो एहसास हैं, कुछ चीज़ों को शब्दों में बयां कर पाना आसान नहीं होता. तो आप सभी का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. आप हमें यूं ही याद करते रहें और हम यूं ही मिलते रहें और हम इस पैंडेमिक से जल्दी से बाहर निकले, मेरी यही दुआ है. आप सभी का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया.
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया सुनीता जी. सुनीता जी, आपको देख के और आपके अल्फाज सुन के बिल्कुल ऐसा लगा कि जैसे हम रेडियो गोल्ड में ही अभी सुन रहे हैं अपनी मीठी आवाज को. तो बहुत अच्छा लगा. और हमें आप जैसे एक रेडियो जॉकी जो हमारे एलुमनाई हमारे ग्रुप के मिले हैं, तो हमें जरूर ये है, एहसास है कि हम जुड़े रहेंगे और आप हम सबको जुड़ाएंगे. ये हमें उम्मीद है कि आप ही हम सबको जुड़ाएंगे.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
थैंक यू, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया.
थैंक यू.
फ्रॉम 82 ईयर ओल्ड रघुनाथन, वी स्ट्रेट कम बैक टू 18 ईयर ओल्ड काव्या स्वामी. शी इज अ भरतनाट्यम डांसर एंड शी इज फ्रॉम 2019 आरकेपुरम स्कूल. कैन आई हैव काव्या? Yeah, Kavya, please come online and speak up.
Good morning and a warm welcome to all. Hope I am audible.
Yeah, go ahead.
Before I introduce myself, I would like to thank Sukumar sir for giving me this opportunity through the platform of Banyan Association. Myself, Kavya Swami, alumni of DT Arkepuram, batch 2019 from Science Stream. So basically, at present, I am preparing for a medical entrance, NEET 2020. And side by side, I am pursuing an art form of Bharatanatyam under my guru, Meenakshi Rao, in which I have completed my diploma and pursuing bachelor from Prachin Kalakendra University from Chandigarh. And recently, due to this pandemic situation, my entrance exam got postponed, and I have utilized my time by doing medical related courses for my future use. So DT Arkepuram plays a very important role in my life. I was a part of DTA since my childhood. I have spent my 13 years in this institution. So basically, I have really have a vast journey and lot to share. But due to constraint of my timing, I would like to share most remembered time of mine. So back to school days, I was a good, bright student which take part in extracurricular activities like sports, culture, exhibition, etc., which try to make equal balance in academic as well. So in the last year, that is 12th standard of my schooling, all the things started getting tangled and messy as I was not able to score that great due to kind of distraction, which I think today also I couldn't able to figure it out. But the speciality is this, that the teacher of the school, they never left you behind. They really try hard to bring you back. In this worried situation of mine, my teachers never let me down. They always motivated me in their own ways. I would like to mention few of them. I would like to start from our principal ma'am, Mrs. Chitra Vasagam. She personally asked me whether there is any problem you are facing which is not letting you to score like the way you score. Then it comes to my class teacher and my physics teacher too, Ms. Poonam Alawat. She provided me with the extra classes until she felt satisfied with my performance. She actually really tried hard to get me back on track. Then my biology teacher, Ms. Selvi, she just never gave up on me at all. She was more confident than me, and I will score great in her subject. She believed that. And you won't believe I did. I scored 88, and I really consider her as one of my idol. Then comes to my English teacher, Mrs. Nandini.
Kavya, that will not be an end to the, you know, thanking the teachers, because I think so many might have, right in your 12 years or 13 years, there might have been a number of teachers who might have inspired you. We have short of time and we have more to go.
Yes. Then I really thank all the teachers who motivated and trusted me. And I am proud to say that I am a DTA student in which the teachers build us. From the similar one, I would like to share one of my personal experience. Few months back after 12th, I was providing tuitions to the students. One of my neighbor, a boy, was really worried of his 10 board exam. I actually provided him with full clearing of concepts and all the things that is in the subject of maths. And within 15 days, I have really made him to thorough all the concepts and made him to score 70% in the final exam.
Thank you so much. And it's really an inspiration that you have just passed out 1 year back and you are, you know, coaching other children. That is really a great job. Thank you very much. We will love to hear from you later also. Right.
Thank you, sir.
So let me pass it on to the next person, V. Ganesh Iyer of 1976 Arkepuram. V. Ganesh Iyer, 1976 Arkepuram, please come online.
Hello.
Yeah, Ganesh.
Hello.
Please carry on.
Hello, I'm Ganesh here this side. Hello, are you able to hear me?
Yeah, we are able to continue.
A big namaskar to all friends, and I'm feeling nice and happy to be participating in this virtual meeting of the Banyan. Namaskarams to all elders. Most of the elders are there in this group, and best wishes to others. I cleared from Arkipuram branch in 1976, and when I got into the school, it was called MEA, and when I left, it was called DTEA. And I happened to now, after about 37 years, I happened to come back to Arkipuram to stay in Arkipuram. Where I'm currently living, I had the privilege of just walking through past the school, and I feel so nostalgic. I must say that not much of the infrastructural change has happened since then, but still I feel so nostalgic about this school. I had completed my graduation and my post-graduation from IFT in Delhi, and then I had been working with Nestle. And a month back, I got retired, and I feel after hearing the this thing from the principal of Arkipuram that the results have been so good, I think I feel so happy that I require. I mean, everybody should come out now. I feel that all the alumni should come back and give back something to the school. And now, since I have retired, I was not able to give my time to due to my official commitments. Now, since I am able to, I am retired now, I'll be able to provide whenever required. I can join the group and give whatever possible from my side. Thank you so much, Sukumarji, for giving me the time for.
Thank you, Ganesh. And that is what the Banyan is looking for, and the school is looking for, that all the alumni should join back and try and do something, whatever best we can all associate together. Can I have Monisha from 2013 RKpuram, if you would like to join? Monisha from 2013 RKpuram. Although I could not speak to her because she just joined yesterday night. Monisha, 2013 RKpuram, would you like to speak? If she is not there, then Raghu Rao, 1981 RKpuram. Raghu Rao, 1981.
Yeah.
Raghu.
Yeah. I am here.
Yeah. Please continue.
Yeah. Okay. So I spent close to 10 years in the school. I passed out in 1981, and it was a great experience. You know, students are still bonded together, so we have our own alumni group within ourselves. And as an outgoing students, we also have contributed to the school in terms of through our own donations, making a AV room and renovation labs, renovation of toilets. We did place CCTV cameras in the school. We also put the for the solar panels. We also set up the digital library, and we also set up the playing area for the small children. And at the request of the principal, we also gave some storage space, accessories to the teachers. So independently, we are a group of 56 students, and we do meet on a regular basis. In fact, yesterday was our meet again, same online meeting. And we have been sharing our experiences of the school. So I think it's a great experience. And yeah, teachers did give us great culture to imbibe in us. And I think we are solid professionals as that we are. And we've been doing well. And thanks to all the teachers in the school. Thank you.
Thank you, Raghu. That was a short and very crisp thing. And you guys have really done quite a lot for the school, we know that. But the accountability factor and the monitoring factor remains a big thing.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, that is where I think we are not able to do. That is why the Banyan or trust has come in, so that, you know, there is some monitoring aspect also.
So if I can interrupt you just for a while, in fact, when we set up the audio visual room, you know, we were surprised to know that the speakers got missing from the school.
That is exactly now, the reason.
So that sends the wrong message. So students who are willing to contribute, you know, may not come up again, you know, knowing that this is what is happening.
That is where we come from. What we are trying to, that is where the parent body is there, because we have an accountability committee. We have everything. So we will have periodical visit. We will have an asset register being maintained by all the principals. And that asset register will be inspected by the team. So that, you know, whatever anybody is donating to the school, that has to be entered in the asset register. And the asset register should be monitored. There should be some checking. Otherwise, whatever you give, you never know what happens to that after that.
I know.
Of course, the principal cannot take all the responsibility of monitoring everything. We as alumni will also have to shoulder that responsibility and do that. Thank you, Raghu, for joining us. Arul Stephen? Can I have Arul Stephen from 2009 Lodhi Estate, please?
Yes, sir.
Arul, please.
Yeah. Hello, everyone, and vanakkam. Innoda androrukum. So let me thank all the members who are behind this initiative of the Banyan, because it was quite difficult for us to engage all the people or the batchmates to bring in a platform where we can share our thoughts, we can contribute our services to the school. So it was a great initiative. So my sincere thanks, heartfelt thanks to the entire team of Banyan. So as a proud alumnus of DPEA, let me introduce myself, Arul Stephen, from the batch of 2009 Lodhi Estate. Currently, I am employed to a private sector in Noida. So as a starting about my school journey, honestly speaking, I have spent around 12 years. 12 good number of years is not an easy thing in one school, particularly where you have learned so much things from the scratch to the pass out thing where you have learned so many things. So later on, I moved to Tamil Nadu for my graduation. So when people there asked, can you read Tamil or write Tamil, or you can choose language as a Tamil? So I said, yes, I was from a Tamil school. And to be one more thing I want to share, I was honored by Delhi Tamil Sangam for being one of the student achieving highest number in language Tamil in the 10th board exams. So it was a great pleasure for me, you know, learning my mother tongue in the northern part, living for you know, my dad's service and being with a family where you can only speak within the family the Tamil language. But I had a great opportunity to enhance my Tamil language in the school as well. So apart from this, I would like to share one more thing. In my bunch of certificates that I have hold in the file that I have, about 70% of the certificates I won from the school itself. Whether it's from the arts competitions or it's from the sports, everything, it was the majority contribution was from the DTEA school only. So, and not simple thanks for the school won't be enough, but I wish to extend my service with my batchmates, with my school friends. Whenever possible, we can contribute or donate whichever area possible, so that we can, you know, show our dedication, show our thanks, show our greatness to the school. So thank you, Sukumar sir, for having me in this conversation.
Thank you, Arul. Thank you so much.
Hello, Chandrasekhar here.
Sir, Chandrasekhar sir, not
one right second.
Now. No, not right now, please. I got not many people. Not right now, please. I will call you later. And you will have to write to me before if you want to speak. Please write, not right now. Can I have Bhagyalakshmi Raman of 1993 RK Puram from Pune? If she is there, please. If she has joined, Bhagyalakshmi Raman from 1993 RK Puram, Pune.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you, all members.
Please speak on.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, Bhagyalakshmi, please continue. Your video is not there, but we can hear you.
Yes, thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. It is a great pleasure to be part of this group, and I thank everyone behind this initiative. It was very great to hear from sir to add me to this Banyan group and to get connected with all the DTA alumni. Recently, like, we do have our WhatsApp group as well, where our batchmates are connected, and we do try to this was the first year when we tried to meet and have a get together for the first time. That was last year in August, and we visited the school. I don't know, might be the other friends would have met earlier also, but for me this was the first year after my pass out in 1993, where I visited the school, and it was a really great moment for me. We met Chitra Vasugam ma'am also, and she also told us what help required by the school and all, and we are trying to do our best from our batch side to help the school and the alumni as such for whatever help from our
Thank
side
you.
Has to be
Thank
done.
You, Thank you very much. Thank you, Bhagyalakshmi. That was Bhagyalakshmi from 1993, RK Puram School, and joining us from Pune. And we will request all those people, your individual group and association should continue, but we will always like if you can share the data with us and also join everybody on the mainstream also, this Banyan, so that we all join together and make it as a big Banyan tree to do things, right? So that is my request for all of you. And can I have Bharani of 1990 Coimbatore, RK Puram 1990. He's joining from Coimbatore. Bharani, if you are there, if you would like to speak. Bharani, if you are there and you would like to speak. Okay, otherwise, Mail Vahanan, another big name in the RK Puram school. Everybody knows, I think, about Mail Vahanan. Quite a lot of people keep talking about him. 1993, RK Puram school. 1993, Mail Vahanan, please come on and speak up, please.
Hi, good afternoon, sir. Thanks for joining me. Sir, as you know, I'm from 1993 batch RK Puram. Currently, I'm working with the Royal Botanist Embassy as administrative officer. The main thing, every student has different type of mindsets. If it is okay if I speak in Tamil, Hindi, three languages, okay?
All the three languages are okay, or even more.
Actually, the thing is that every student has different type of mindsets. Somebody is having some different like electronics and all. Since small from school time, I had lots of interest in electronics actually. And the time of 93, even if you afford for that, it was like Pentium 4 was near about 54,000 rupees at that time. It's not possible for our parents to get it. Now it is like not only Banyan, ellarume ipo vandu or funding pannadunala or ella school kume or vishayangal kadachirukku. Now they have to best use ipo pannanum students ku nalla or platform ipo neenga pandringa. So I'm very happy with joining with Banyan. I got more interest when I came to that Atal Tinkering Lab inauguration in Pusa Road. When I got some ideas, ipdiyum pandradhukku mudiyuma appdiyana school la na adukku munadi paathadilla namm adum DTL la indha mari vishayangal la nadakkum appdinuttu. It was something like a dream. Even I can say enak appo irundhe or interest irukkradanal ippovum na indha mari electronics panna undiyum enak or interest adala undu. Ippom currently I am having, besides my official that work, I'm having high-tech solutions, advanced technologies. I have two more small companies which I'm doing currently. Also yesterday I made I can show you a small it's a sensor, proximity sensor, oda or chinna vishayam pannirken, sanitizer with remote one which I'm doing. This is just part of enak or interest idla or hobby. Even my child, she's also doing some science experiments. Indha mari vishayangal nariya nadandute irukum engalukku. So I'm very much happy. At the same time, ipo neenga sonninga ஆடியோ விஷுவல் அது இதுன்ற ஸ்கூலில் வந்து எனக்கு வந்து இந்த எலக்ட்ரானிக்ஸ் இப்போ டிஜிட்டல் லைப்ரரி இதெல்லாம் அவங்க சொன்னதெல்லாம் எனக்கு ஒரு இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட். நானும் போயிருக்கேன், பார்த்துருக்கேன் எல்லா விஷயத்துலையும். இந்த மாதிரி எதுவும் எனி கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஹெல்ப் ஐ எம் ரெடி டு டூ. As I joined in 2015 with the CCTV cameras fixing in RKpuram first time. Before that, I went there 3-4 times to tell them what are the useful advantages. But Maithili madam, and later I met Mr. Rajeshwar Shastri sir and Mr. Kotni. They believed that I can do something for the school at that time because அவங்களுக்கும் ஒரு நம்பிக்கை இல்லை தான் அந்த நேரத்தில் இப்படி எல்லாம் பண்ணுறதுக்கு பெட்டரா ஒருத்தர் பண்ண முடியுமான்னு. தென் ஒன் பை ஒன் ஐ கனெக்டட் வித் ஆல் த 7 ஸ்கூல்ஸ். நவ் ஐ எம் கனெக்டட் வித் மலாய் மந்திர், காமாட்சி டெம்பிள், ராம் மந்திர் இன் துவார்கா அண்ட் லாட்ஸ் ஆஃப் அதர் ப்ரைவேட் ஹோம்ஸ் அண்ட் ஆல். ஈவன் ஐ காட் அ அவார்ட் ஃப்ரம் தமிழ் சங்கம் ஃபார் டூயிங் சம்திங் ஃபார் த தமிழ் கம்யூனிட்டி ஆக்சுவலி இன் தீஸ் ஏரியாஸ். So enakkor nalla interest. Last time I tried my best to bring all the 1993 batch students to Delhi from different states and brought them to school just to have a see ki aapka school kitna aage badh raha hai, kya ho raha hai, aap dekhiye. Even I'm trying them to join with Banyan because I found it's a good platform nalla ideas irukku Banyan la. Ipa neraya per irukkradanaala ipa munnadi vande engalukku andha maadhiri பேக்கப் எதுவும் அவ்வளவா இல்ல. ஸோ வி காட் லாட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஐடியாஸ் டு டூ ஃபார் ஸ்கூல்ஸ் பட் வி டோன்ட் ஹேவ் எனி பேக்கப். இப்போ இவ்வளோ பேரை நான் பார்த்ததுக்கு அப்புறம் வி ஆர் கான்ஃபிடென்ட் இப்போ கண்டிப்பாக இது மாதிரி பண்ண முடியும் பிகாஸ் வி கேன் டூ அவர் ஐடியாஸ். நிறைய புது புது ஐடியாஸ் இருக்கு, எல்லாமே பண்ண முடியும். பட் த ஒன்லி திங் வித் த ஃபைனான்சியல் மேட்டர்ஸ். ஸோ ஐ ஸ்டில் கோ டு ஆர்கிபுரம் ஸ்கூல் எவ்ரி டைம். நாட் ஒன்லி டு ஆர்கிபுரம், ஐ கோஸ் டு மந்திர் மார்க், பூசா ரோட், ஜனக்புரி, எவ்ரி ஸ்கூல். இப்போ வந்து ஆல்ரெடி ஐ எம் ஒன்லி ஹேண்ட்லிங் ஆல் த கேமரா இஷ்யூஸ். வாட் எவர் ஐ செட், புதுசாக இப்போ காசு போட்டு ரெடி பண்ணுறது ஒரு பெரிய விஷயம் இல்லை, பட் யூ ஹாவ் டு ஹேண்டில் இட் ஃபார் அ லாங்கர் பீரியட். அதுதான் இப்போ அதை நம்ம பார்க்காம விட்டுட்டா இட் இஸ் யூஸ்லெஸ். ஈவன் இஃப் யூ ஆர் புட்டிங் லேக்ஸ் ஆஃப் ருபீஸ், அதை நம்ம ஜஸ்ட் ஒரு 1000 ருபீஸ்க்காக விட்டு வச்சுட்டு உட்காந்துட்டு இருந்தாங்கன்னா அது கெட்டு போயிடும். இந்த மாதிரி விஷயங்கள். ஸோ ஐ எம் ஹாப்பி. ஸோ
யூ ஆர் வெரி ரைட். We will continue with that and please do
thank you.
Be
thank
in touch
you,
with us.
So thank now- you.